So when we filmed this tour for you guys, she was not sea trialed yet and was not in the water. So we had to travel a little bit. Are we gonna take it for a spin?
Let's go.
All right, let's do this.
We have perfect weather. 1 meter sea.
Nice.
Oh boy.
Well, this is fun.
Not yet.
No, but I'm...
Not yet.
I am really excited that we get to do this.
So where are we, Victoria?
We are in France. We're in the south of France. The Hysucat has made it out here to the show, so we get to show you guys what it can do.
And for all you Alexei fans, we got the man back.
He's
on
back.
The channel.
Hello.
Hi guys, welcome back to NautiStyles. We are at the BERING shipyard in Antalya, Turkey, and we're here to show you Hysucat. Hysucat is one of the brands produced by the BERING Group, and this is the Hysucat 28. Are gonna do a detailed tour. Why is it called Hysucat?
Hydrofoil supported catamaran.
Hydrofoil supported catamaran. Hysucat.
Right.
Duh.
Cool thing is, it is a rib.
It is.
You can use it as a yacht tender easily. You have the pontoons around, but you don't need the pontoons to float.
No, boat is floating, pontoons are not touching the water. Pontoons are not participating in a motion mode. The pontoons are your oversized fenders and your safety, because it's have a 7 compartments. We had one customer who forgot the plugs, and the boat was fully filled up with water, and it's get on pontoons.
Yeah.
And he called us and said the boat is not performing the way it's performed at the sea trial. He was complaining the speed and consumption went completely down, and he didn't understand what's going on. We advise to open up any compartment and he see the boat is full of water. So the plugs.
That's funny. So what is so unique about this boat? I mean, first of all, it's a catamaran, right?
We call it catamaran because it's two sponsons. Technically, it's a catamaran.
Yeah.
But what it is, it's a monohull with carved inside tonneau. And then we introduce the foil in between the sponsons, which carry about 65% of the weight when we're underway. So you can see, this is the tunnel. You see further down there is the foil, main foil, with one center strut. This foil is actually carrying the whole boat up. And then two small foils near the stern, they're balancing the boat out. This boat is not actually a planing boat, it's a foiling boat. The resistance and the friction is way lower. So the consumption of this boat built with this technology, we're beating the monohull by twice.
Wow.
We're twice more economical. The friction is not there. We're flying. It's not only supported by the foil, it's also supported by compressed air, which is pumped by this big mouth. Airflow is going under the boat.
So you're right, and on it's, an air cushion almost.
It's an air cushion. It's kicked in after about 34 knots, let's say 2 feet chop, you better speed up rather than slow down.
It makes it more comfortable.
It's make it more comfortable and softer ride. We experienced it yesterday.
Correct.
When we were riding.
Yeah.
So you've seen when the chop start to be bigger, instead of slow down, I speed up.
Who doesn't want to do that?
Yeah, right?
When it's rougher outside. So here on the transom, you can actually see, by the way, that no drain plugs are in. Just wanted to mention before you put in the water. So here in the back, let me have the camera for a second. Here you see the aft facing winglets on each side. So they're supporting the stern portion of the boat. So you're actually picking the stern up a little bit as well.
Yeah, and you see here is a semi-surface piercing props.
Yeah.
They're doing well here because the cavitation plates are higher than on normal boats. This is your running surface here.
Okay. So that's where you're judging from, yeah?
Yeah, so you can see how high the pontoons from actually the water surface which we're running on. So when we're floating, we are submerged by about this level, where you see
the bottom paint.
So the boat is floating without tubes participated in this.
Yeah.
You see the engines, they're 12 degrees off vertical because the sponsons are asymmetrical and we're catching better flow of water. We couldn't spread that wide because then pontoons would be affected. So we decide to incline the engines inward to catch the best flow to the prop area.
Understand. So what is the top speed in this configuration?
I'm afraid to say with pair of 200 Verados, official record was 82 miles per hour.
What?
With pair of 200, 82 miles per hour.
What?
It's been done in Sweden.
Wow. What really like stands out for me immediately are these racing chairs at the stern.
I mean, who doesn't want to sit in this doing 50 knots?
Is this gel coat?
No, it's ALEXEI paint. It's the same paint we're using for our super yachts.
So let's check everything out here.
I have a table here, teak table. This is artificial teak, right?
Yes.
Okay, cool. And then here.
Oh wait, there's storage underneath?
Oh no. It's a little wet bar. Is there a shower here?
Yes, there is. Uh-huh. Right here.
Check it out. I'm like, what else do you need for like a day out on the islands? You need this, you need that, maybe a day ahead, right? And some storage to put a cooler or maybe a refrigerator.
Yep.
So I guess you can add on a cooler here, have a fridge. This is Hyperlon, right?
That is Hyperlon, yes.
Okay, I really like this.
On this one, they used the carbon fiber print on it. It looks pretty cool. I really dig it.
Well, okay, wait, before you get to the ground, this is aesthetically so beautiful. I really like this.
The support of the hardtop?
Yeah, it's this whole hardtop structure is gorgeous.
Well, and also like when we took the boat out yesterday, what I really liked is no matter how rough the sea is or what kind of crazy turns you're doing, you always have something to grab onto.
Yep, the rails everywhere.
You got the rails overhead and then the support structure here. I was holding on a lot here or even up here.
Yeah,
like
exactly.
All the time.
It's really well designed. You also have this as well that you can grab onto right here as well. I mean, it's just everywhere.
And it's kind of cool because it's incorporated. So it's not even like a mounted grab handle, which is kind of like unpleasing to the eye. Like here you actually have just organically.
I just think the console hardtop connected structure thingy, whatever you guys want to call it, the lines on this is very sexy.
Yeah, very sporty looking, very aerodynamic.
Yeah, all right, what's here?
Pretty packed cockpit here. So we have a Garmin chart plotter mounted right here. This is the Mercury engine monitor, fusion stereo, VHF radio, bilge pumps, and then all our switches, 12 volt DC stuff, low volt stuff, which we have on the boat, like the horn, water pump, etc. Underwater lights, running lights, and so on. What?
Underwater lights.
Yeah.
I like it.
And I saw, you know what? This actually has underwater lights also mounted forward.
Stop it.
Inwards.
No.
Yeah. Like on the inside of the pontoons.
Oh, that's amazing.
Pretty cool.
Oh, that's right, because it's a cat.
Yes. So shift roll controls and the helm.
And a really, really beautiful steering wheel. Did I say it was beautiful?
It's and
beautiful.
A compass. Forgot about that.
And a compass. How about the seats? What do you think of them?
I like them.
Most of the time, you never sit when you're driving a tender. You always stand. So I feel like for you, this would be
it's also
perfectly fine.
Safe. Very because
safe.
If you do some really sharp turns, you have a little extra support that you don't fly overboard.
Moving forward.
This quick here is the fuel fill right here, conveniently.
Look at all the rails everywhere. They're just really cool. Just all the stainless steel work. It looks really beautiful. And those vents, why do we have those, Rico?
Because this boat is capable of doing really high speeds. I mean, we're talking like 60, 70 knots. The air which would be trapped in there would actually function as kind of like a wing.
Yeah.
And you don't want to have more uplift than you need. So
yeah, no kidding.
So they put the grill in there so the air can escape and also doesn't slow you down.
Back to the fun parts.
That is a really, really nice layout cushion.
Oh.
Right?
Yes. I want to be back in the Kekava Island right now on this thing. This is gorgeous.
Really
so
cool.
So I see that there's some, well, first of all, I'm an ankle locker here.
Oh, okay.
And also these pop-up cleats here.
Yep.
Cool. And these look like there's something underneath because they're all separated. Let's try this. Oh yeah, open this up right there.
Oh wow.
Dang.
That is a quite deep storage. I mean, you can fit your fenders in here, dock lines. You can even put like a cooler in here or something if you want to, or make it a fish hold.
And it's on both sides. And I like, look how everything, it just fits perfectly. You know,
your
cushions are not flying away, sure. And here we also have some more storage.
More storage, yeah.
Love it.
Pretty awesome.
The one thing would be nice to have on the boat like this is a day head. This I cheated, I asked, so I know this for sure. The day head could go right here with a curtain that just drops down. And right here you also have a fuel tank too.
So yeah, so this boat has two separate fuel tanks.
Wow.
One on each side, one for each engine.
Oh, okay,
yes.
Cool. Got it.
20 gallons each side, so a total of 40 gallons of fuel.
So how is the fuel consumption on this thing?
Amazing.
Did you guys talk about it?
It's about half of what a monohull is using at the same speed.
No way.
Comparatively.
So, do we know what, like, how far can we go on this thing?
I believe this one with this configuration, the way it is right now here, about 200 nautical miles.
So easily from Florida to the Bahamas for a day and back, no problem at all.
No problem at all.
Fabulous.
We're back on the Hysucat. What kind of engines do we have on this one here?
Wrong engines. They're too powerful. We don't even know how fast this boat can go. That's how much power they're packing. It's a pair of 300 Mercuries V8. It's a massive engine. We just wanted to try because it's not recommended power for this model. Mm-hmm. Pair of 200s, sufficient enough. And for commercial use, most of our customers installing 140 Suzuki, 150 Yamaha, even down to 115, and it's carried up to 14 passengers.
Wow.
You know those crazy videos you watch with the Russians where they do things that just like way out? We just wanted to try the bigger engines and see what I can do.
Yeah, it's good we didn't put some jet turbine
No kidding.
Because it's pretty much the same. So it's certified, it's C certified, class B, which is pretty good. It's, you can go far in pretty nasty condition. It's class B, C certification for 14 people. The range of this boat is about 250 miles.
We're gonna get a little bit of a front wash because, well, that's how it is in France. Woo!
You see the sea condition, it's pretty confusing.
It is not a flat condition at all, you guys.
What do we have, like 1 meter waves?
Yeah, for sure. And it's like a chop, so it's really short and all over the place. So it's, it's pretty amazing. Wow.
Amazing.
Woo!
40.
We're doing 40 knots.
So you can see it can go pretty much any direction.
Yep. Let's go big wave. Oh, you didn't even feel it.
What?
There was a bigger wave, we didn't even feel it.
No.
Nothing.
Yeah, actually, when we slow down,
actually, you feel more.
This is unthinkable on anything else. That is crazy.
That was 40 knots.
Wow. And it was really comfortable.
Let me explain you why.
Yeah.
because it's unique for this craft. As you know, it's a hydrofoil. It's a cat. It's two asymmetrical holes with a hydrofoil in between and two little winglets on the back for stability, for longitudinal stability. As you notice, I didn't touch anything. This boat doesn't have any trim tabs or anything like this. You don't have to operate this boat. You just throttle and throttle back. That's it. And the wheel.
So much washier from the
You see how we're rocking and rolling right now.
Yeah, exactly. So, now you can tell how actually the conditions are.
On the waves like this, your monohull would give you a miserable ride.
Yeah, it would be
absolutely
miserable.
Horrible. Yeah. You would probably have to think about your back, about your neck and everything.
Yeah, because
you
can't get really above it enough. Yeah. To just and completely ride it, and
combination
so you just go
of
slow.
Air cushion and a foil, really dampening the impact accelerations, and you feel comfortable. Although you feel something, but it's underneath of you. So we have foil which take the first impact, because probably a few times we get airborne and landed back.
I mean, really?
Yes.
Yeah.
I was in the back. I just
at like 52 knots, we got a little bit airborne. Yeah.
I was kind of holding on. Well, actually, I wasn't holding at all. I was actually just sitting, but I felt like I was hanging in for my dear life because we were so fast. Wow, and I'm not used to it. It's like it's in your head. When you see this kind of conditions and you're on the tender, you just kind of don't.
You're normally tensing up.
Yeah, you tense up because you think you're going to have some really hard impacts.
Yes, and this boat is very, very smooth. It's economical because we have much less drag. Depends on the load, depends on the model. We start foiling from 16 to 20 knots. And then it's changed the quality of ride immediately. On some models, twice more economical than monohulls. Of course, on the rough sea condition like today, not rough, but sort of moderate, of course consumption will increase, but it's still much lower than monohull. On average, for this model, we go on close to 4 miles per gallon.
Four miles per gallon.
Yeah, this is pretty heavy boat. This boat is almost 5,000 pounds.
No, it's really good. 4 miles per gallon.
Yeah,
4 miles per gallon. But lightly loaded. I mean, it was like 4, 5, 6 people.
Yeah.
When you put the full load, 14 people, of course, the consumption is different.
Yeah, for sure.
The advantages of this boat is smooth ride. I would put it on the first place. The second one is a fuel economy, and it's where our commercial clientele kick in. When you taxi or ferry, you're doing 50 trips to the island and back. Fuel is about half of your expense.
Yeah,
so
but that,
you're
that's,
cutting it.
That's amazing. I mean, that makes it a perfect tender because you're literally not really thinking about fuel the whole time. You can literally go all day long, do a whole bunch of snorkeling, this, that, run around, and you're not even really thinking about it. That's a huge. Peace of mind too.
And another advantage, it's a dry ride because we're so high above the water.
Yeah.
The spray is taking off pretty much right here where I'm showing. It's not here, not forward, because if we would go flat, the spray would take off here and the wind will blow it on you, but the spray is taken off and blown onto the engines.
Yeah.
If that, or mostly behind.
Exactly.
So it's a dry, comfortable, smooth ride. It's fuel saving, and you are faster than anyone out there in a given sea condition. That's for sure. I'm not talking about special boats like racing boats or formulas, which can go 100 miles. So, but this boat is not aim, it's a workhorse.
Exactly.
It's either a good luxury tender, like we're using it. All the Bering's current owners bought one of the Hysucats, not necessarily this model, some bigger, and right now the boat 145 foot under construction, where the Hysucat 38 will be the tender. 38 with diesel power, it will be the tender, towing tender, of course.
Definitely cool having a diesel tender, because then you can actually fill her up from the mothership.
Yes, there are diesels for this size of the boat. There is oxy diesel.
Mm-hmm.
They have a line from 150 to 300 horsepower. And it's a new company from England, Cox.
Yep.
They have a 300 horsepower diesels. The torque is double compared to gasoline.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So if this boat requires a pair of 200, it's best performance with pair of 200. Doesn't matter what Suzuki, Yamaha, Mercury, Honda. With the diesel, 150 would be enough. It will be way more economical, and we can fuel from the fuel tank of the big boat. For the tender, I would recommend it to use with the diesel power. It comes with a price tag. It's double compared to the gasoline engine at this point in time, but I think it will come down a little bit when popularity will grow.
Yeah.
Because I'm somehow connected to Bering.
Somehow?
I have to say that we cannot imagine you to be on the Bering without this thing behind us.
Yeah. That's your. Yeah. That's what you have in tow.
Yeah, because it's similar, like you have a nice big RV with a car behind.
Yeah.
Because it would be not a good idea to go shopping an RV and everything else. So the point is, the Bering can stay out for indefinite period of time. We need just fuel once a year, or maybe twice. And
this is your car.
That's about it. And this is what we do. We're exploring on this boat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very fast exploring.
We definitely, because if you have, let's say, 5 hours to go on Bering, it's 30 miles. It's about 40 minutes, 30 minutes on this one.
It's amazing. You can cover so much ground.
You can get inexpensively to any marina. Usually, like when we go at night, in the morning, if we not reach the destination yet, we jump into Hysucat, go there in the morning, where we want to be.
Yep.
Spend all day exploring.
That's
and
perfect.
Get back, and Bering never stops. We have to chase it another 30 miles because it's already forward. So
that's
it's
amazing.
How you can travel fast on a slow boat with this rig. It's the rig which is capable of travel in real sea condition, which we have now.
Oh yeah, and this is an uncomfortable. Important. I mean, I don't know if that actually shows on the camera, but I can tell you guys, this is a very uncomfortable short wind chop here. And big boat traffic as well, so it's not something which usually is fun in a small boat.
Even in a big boat, this is
yeah. We
this
start
isn't
to
fun.
Have white cups here and there.
Yeah,
now.
Yeah, yeah.
This wouldn't be too much fun in our boat. Like you would definitely be rolling.
Oh yeah, for sure.
For sure.
This is a very, very comfortable speed. No banging, no nothing.
This is so nice!
It's really nice, even on the bow.
We can change the direction. We can go against the waves.
This is great speed. How fast is this?
Like
20.
So for what hours now? 3 months, we can have one. So what is the size ranges?
23 foot through 80.
80? Well, that's no longer a tender.
No.
Oh.
80? 80. 80 what?
Yeah, we have developed 80
what
foot.
What does 80 look like?
I will show you.
I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I think this is something to definitely look out for. I think it's gonna make some waves, pun intended, on the tender market. So thanks again for showing us around. I feel like we live here now. We live in Bering. I'm pretty sure you're gonna have some questions on this one. I'm sure there's things we didn't cover. So put them down in the comments below. We'll communicate, we get them answered. And if you guys are interested in purchasing one, all the content information will be underneath the video. Make sure you check it out. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. We are in the shipyard. So, enjoy the outtakes. Thanks for watching. Ciao. Now we need to cut and then come back.
This is the Hysucat.
Okay. Let's finish this.
Okay.
Blowing you up? He's a busy man. I don't know how we got him for so long.
So
he must like us.
I'm enjoying it.
He must like us. Okay. All right. You guys should see how many people are saying hello to him at the show and saying, I saw it on the YouTube channel.
So
So this aircraft,
probably slowly go, and when people watching it on the camera,
yeah, they're
literally
gonna be
going
seasick,
like this.
Yeah.
Let's go for a ride.
Are you gonna film from here?
No, are we gonna take it for a spin?
Oh yeah, guys, let's come over.
Bad acting.
We have perfect.
Take two. Do it again. Part of the Bering Group, and we're
what? This is the Hysucat 28.
Oh, come on.
Just say this is.
We're bringing back the man himself, the man, the legend, the myth. Sorry, guys, we tried it without sunglasses, but we just can't do it. So here we go. We're all souped up now.
And we're gonna geek out.
Саш, я тебе перезвоню сейчас в фильме. Перезвоню тебе, ладно?
80s. Ага. 80s music.
When do we get ours? That's what I want to know.
2 months.
2 months. So if you order one, it's 2 months. No, 3 months. What?
It's three.
What? 3 months.
Better three. I would say three. Two, but he would say three.
Okay.